Good morning, students of class 4. Students, I'm sure all of you are happy and healthy. Students, in my last video, I had completed exercise C of comprehension and frame sentences of lesson 3 of your Wordsworth English Reader book, The Blind Man and the Elephant. And today I'll be continuing with the language structure exercise of this lesson. So all of you, please take out your Wordsworth English Reader book and notebooks. Students, please take out your English notebook and your Wordsworth English Reader book. Turn the page to page number 23. Lesson 3, The Blind Man and the Elephant. Students, please take out your English notebook and your Wordsworth English Reader book. Turn the page to page number 23, lesson 3, The Blind Man and the Elephant. Students, first of all, today I'm going to revise the 3 exercises of comprehension, make sentences, and then I'll be starting with the language structure exercise. So all of you, please take out your notebooks. I'll be revising exercise A. Answer the following questions briefly. Students, the first question is, who had brought the elephant to the village? What was the elephant's name? The answer is, a wise man had brought the elephant to the village. The elephant's name was Gajju. Question number 2. Why weren't people afraid of the elephant? Answer 2 is, Gajju was a tame animal, so no one was afraid of him. Question 3. What was different about the 4 friends? The answer is, all of them were blind. Question 4. Did the 4 friends describe the elephant in the same manner? The answer is, no, the 4 friends did not describe the elephant in the same manner. Question 5. What did the wise man tell the 4 friends? The answer is, the wise man told the 4 friends that they should have pooled their information instead of arguing over who was right. Question 6. What did the 4 friends realize finally? The answer is, the 4 friends realized their mistake and did as advised by the wise man. Thus, they were finally able to get a clear picture of the animal in their mind. Now, exercise B. Each blind man touched a different body part and formed an impression of the elephant. In the exercise below, write the body parts of the elephant that the blind man touched when he gave the following description. The first one, it is like a tree. So which body part of the elephant was it? The elephant's leg. Second, it's like a snake. Which body part of the elephant? The answer is the elephant's trunk. The third is, it's like a rope. Which body part of the elephant? The elephant's tail. Fourth, it's like a fan. The body part is the elephant's ear. Now, exercise C, that is, think and answer the following questions. Question 1. Why was there a difference of opinion among the 4 friends? The answer is, there was a difference of opinion among the 4 friends because each one of them was describing only a part of the big animal. They all had their own view of what the elephant was like. Each of them thought that he was right. Again, I'm repeating answer 1 of exercise 3. C. There was a difference of opinion among the 4 friends because each one of them was describing only a part of the big animal. They all had their own view of what the elephant was like. Each of them thought that he was right. Question 2. Do you agree that the 4 friends represent people who are inflexible in their thinking? Answer 2. Yes, I agree that the 4 friends represent people who are inflexible in their thinking because they do not examine a matter from all sides. They believe certain things to be facts without verifying the source. Again, I'm repeating answer 2. Yes, I agree that the four friends represent people who are inflexible in their thinking because they do not examine a matter from all sides. They believe certain things to be fact without verifying the source. Question 3. Is it a good thing to be rigid in our thinking? Answer is no, it is not a good thing to be rigid in our thinking because everyone looks at things from different angles. We should appreciate other people's opinion. This will help us in improving our relations. Again, I'm repeating answer 3. No, it is not a good thing to be rigid in our thinking because everyone looks at things from different angles. We should appreciate other people's opinion. This will help us in improving our relations. Now, students, I'm going to revise the frame sentences. The first word is argue, and argue means quarrel, and the sentence is, I'm not in the mood to argue. The sentence is, I'm not in a mood to argue. Then the second word is opined, which means give opinion. And the sentence is, the teacher opined that the picnic would make a nice change. Again, I'm repeating. The sentence is, the teacher opined that the picnic would make a nice change. The third word is tame, which means gentle. And the sentence is, it is difficult to tame a tiger. Again, I'm repeating, it is difficult to tame a tiger. Then the fourth word is appreciate. Appreciate means to praise. And the sentence is, I appreciate your help very much. The word is appreciate and the sentence is, I appreciate your help very much. Fifth word is eager. Eager means curious to know. And the sentence is, the students were eager to know their result. The sentence is, the students were eager to know their result. So we have revised the comprehension exercises and the frame sentences. Now students, please take out your English, Wordsworth English Reader book and turn to page 24 as I'll be starting with language structure exercise. And the first exercise is based on synonyms. Now, what do you mean by synonyms? हमारी पहली exercise है वो synonyms पे based है. Beta, synonyms are the words which have got the same meaning. ठीक है? Synonym वो words हैं जिनके meaning same होते हैं. ठीक है? Now, in this students, first we will take this exercise has to be done in the notebook also. So first we'll write some words and their synonyms. पहले हम कुछ बेटा word लिखेंगे and synonyms. Word and their synonym. So that you learn. The first word is pupil. पहला word क्या है? Pupil. Synonym मतलब same meaning का word. तो pupil का synonym is student. What is the synonym of pupil? Pupil का synonym क्या है? Student. दोनों word का meaning same है. ठीक है? So the synonym of pupil is student. Then the second word is gave, fine, or gave gave ka synonym is delivered, delivered, gave, delivered, dono ke meaning same hai. Synonyms are the words which have got the same meaning. Then the third word is enough. Enough matlab kafi. And the synonym of enough is sufficient. There was sufficient water in the pond. There was enough water in the pond. Fine. There was enough food on the table. There was sufficient food on the table. Then the fourth word is poor, and the synonym of poor is deprived. Poor deprived. The synonym of poor is deprived, and the fifth word is quietly. And the synonym of quietly is silently. The synonym of quietly is silently. Clear? So, first I've written the synonym so that you can write the word and the synonym. The first synonyms, again I'm repeating, synonyms are the words which have got the same meaning. Synonyms are the words which have got the same meaning. The first word is pupil, and pupil means student. The second word is gave, and the synonym is delivered. The third word is enough, and the synonym is, sorry, I have written the incorrect spelling. I'll correct it. It is S-U-F-F-I-C-I-E-N-T, sufficient. Maine galti se usme C-I likhna, I forgot. So, I've written S-U-F-F-I-C-I-E-N-T. That's the reason, students, हम आपसे बोलते हैं revise करो, है ना? गलती किसी से भी हो सकती है ना? अभी मैंने revise किया तो मुझे अपनी mistake पकड़ में आई. तो same way आप भी revise करो so that you can also catch hold of your mistake and rectify it. Clear? So enough, the synonym is sufficient. S-U-F-F-I-C-I-E-N-T. अगर मैं revise नहीं करती तो आपको मैं गलत spelling सिखा देती. So please revise whatever you write so that you can rectify your mistake. The fourth word is poor, and the synonym is derived. Deprived. D-E-P-R-I-V-E-D, deprived. Poor, deprived. D-E-P-R-I-V-E-D, deprived. The fifth word is quietly, and the synonym is silently. S-I-L-E-N-T-L-Y. Fine. I hope everyone has written these synonyms. Now I'm going to start with exercise A. Fine. So, right now you do this exercise in your English notebook, and for your homework you will do it in your book. ठीक है? Book में क्योंकि खाली आपको blank लिखना है, but I'll give the heading first. Exercise A. Write the synonyms for the underlined words in the given sentences use the words from the help box If you can't think of one, अगर आप सोच नहीं पाते हो आप help box में से word use कर सकते हो. Fine? Okay. अब हमको sentence में एक word दिया है underline, उसका synonym लिख के dash में आपको book में लिखना है, but in your notebook आप फिर से sentence लिखोगे. I am a sincere, pupil at school. I am a sincere pupil at school. This is the sentence, and the word is pupil. Now we need to find the synonym of pupil and rewrite the sentence again. Clear? तो हमारा सेंटेंस क्या हो जाएगा? I am a sincere pupil का synonym क्या है? Student. So we write student at school. I am a sincere student at school. Done? Okay. Draw parting line after each sentence. Then the second one. The postman gave the letter. The postman gave the letter at my father's office. And the word is gave. We need to find the synonym of gave. And the synonym of gave is delivered. So our sentence will be, the postman delivered the letter at my father's office. The postman delivered the letter at my father's office. So the synonym of gave is deliver. Fine. Now the third one. We did not carry, enough water, with us for the picnic. The word is enough and the synonym of enough is sufficient. So we'll rewrite this sentence using the synonym. So our sentence will be, we did not carry sufficient. We did not carry sufficient water with us for the picnic. This is our sentence. I hope everyone has written. और जो मैं next line वाला word लिख रही हूँ वो आपको book में जो dash दिया है blank उसमें आपको भरना है. So I'll once again I'll revise these three sentences and then I'm going to erase and write the fourth one. The first one is, I'm a sincere pupil at school. The synonym of pupil is student. So our sentence is, I'm a sincere student at school. The second one is, the postman gave the letter at my father's office. The synonym of gave is delivered. And the sentence is, the postman delivered the letter at my father's office. Then the third word is, third sentence, sorry, is, we did not carry enough water with us for the picnic. The synonym of enough is sufficient. So our sentence is, we did not carry sufficient water with us for the picnic. So now I'm going to erase these sentences, students, and write the fourth one. fourth sentence is, one can see many poor children in the slums. अब बेटा slums क्या होते हैं? Slums वो जगह होती है जहां पे अब जैसे पक्के मकान नहीं होते हैं ना, झुग्गी झोपड़ियां बनी रहती है ना। अब जो लोग गरीब होते हैं उनके पास पक्के मकान बनाने के तो पैसे नहीं है, तो बेचारे झोपड़ी बना के रहते हैं, है ना। आप देखते हो उधर लाइट नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है ना। आप ट्रेन से जाते हो तो आप देखते हो कि स्लम्स में लाइट्स नहीं है, छोटी छोटी झोपड़ियों में एक ही रूम्स में कई सारे लोग रहते हैं, वाटर कनेक्शन नहीं है, इलेक्ट्रिक कनेक्शन नहीं है ना। बिना मतलब मिनिमम चीजों के साथ वो लोग सर्वाइव करते हैं, सो उसको हम स्लम्स बोलते हैं। एंड पुअर का सिनोनिम क्या है? डिप्राइव्ड। सो आवर सेंटेंस विल बी, वन कैन सी मेनी डिप्राइव्ड चिल्ड्रन in the slums. This is our sentence. One can see many deprived children in the slums. Then the fifth one, the last sentence of this exercise. The cat, quietly pounced. The cat quietly pounced on the rat. The cat quietly pounced on the rat. Sorry, it's not pounce. Pounce means to jump and attack. The word is quietly. अब हमको quietly का synonym लिखना है। Pounce means jump and attack, है ना? The cat silently, quietly का synonym क्या है? Silently pounced on the rat. The cat silently pounced on the rat. Fine. So with this, we have finished our exercise A of language structure. Clear? I hope everyone has done. I'll revise and then I'm going to erase it. The fourth one. One can see many poor children in these slums, and the sentence with the synonym of poor is deprived, that is, one can see many deprived children in the slums. The fifth one is, the cat quietly pounced on the rat, and the synonym of quietly is silently. The sentence is, the cat silently pounced on the rat. So now I'm going to erase this and I'm going to start with the spell check exercise. So all of you, please do exercise B in the book itself. Exercise B, huh? बुक में ही करेंगे। स्पेल चेक एक्सरसाइज है, दैट मीन्स टू चेक योर स्पेलिंग्स। ओके, एंड द एक्सरसाइजेस चेक पेज नंबर 24। डू दिस एक्सरसाइज इन द बुक इटसेल्फ। चेक द स्पेलिंग्स of the following words and make corrections where required. and make corrections where required. और जहां जरूरत है गलत स्पेलिंग है वहां हमको ठीक करके लिखना है. फाइन. सो डू दिस एक्सरसाइज इन द बुक इटसेल्फ. क्लियर. द फर्स्ट वर्ड इज A X E C L A I M E D A X or claim. So this is a incorrect spelling. The correct spelling of exclaimed is exclaimed means. The correct spelling of exclaimed is EX. ये X तो कुल्हाड़ी वाला X हुआ. Correct spelling is EXCLAIMED. Exclaim means to shout loudly. Fine. So the correct spelling is EXCLAIMED. Exclaimed. हमने करेक्ट स्पेलिंग लिखी. नाउ द सेकेंड वर्ड इज ए पी आर ओ पी आर ए टी ई. अप्रोप्रिएट. अप्रोप्रिएट नहीं होता है. दिस इज अप्रोप्रिएट. एकदम सही. अप्रोप्रिएट. द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग इज ए डबल पी R O P R I A T E. A double P R O P R I T E. A double P R O P R I A T E. Appropriate. Clear? This is the correct spelling. Then the third word is routine. That is R O U T I N. This is again incorrect spelling. The correct spelling is R O U T I N E. Routine, जो हम काम लगातार करते हैं, रोज करते हैं, है ना. जो हमारा रोज जो हम काम करते हैं वो हमारा रूटीन है. जैसे हमारा रूटीन है कि हम मॉर्निंग में उठते हैं, वी अटेंड दी योगा क्लासेस, आफ्टर दैट वी अटेंड दी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. And you watch video, then you do your homework. So this you repeat it every day. So this is your routine. Then the fourth word is C-O-N-V-I-N-S-E. Galat. This is again incorrect spelling. The correct spelling is of convince is C-O-N-V-I-N-C-E. Convince karna kisi ko kisi cheez ke liye. समझा देना, मना लेना, कन्विंस कर लेना. क्लियर. देन द फिफ्थ वर्ड इज आर्ग्यूइंग. बहस करना, लड़ना. एंड अगेन दिस इज एन इनकरेक्ट स्पेलिंग. द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग में ई नहीं आता है. दैट इज ए आर जी यू आई एन जी. आर्ग्यूइंग. क्लियर. फाइन. नाउ आई revise all these spellings once again. Exclaimed means to shout loudly and this is the incorrect spelling. Ya to AXX kulhari wala X spell hai ya fir claimed hai. Incorrect. Jo correct spelling hogi wo hogi EXCLAIMED. Exclaimed. Then the next word is appropriate. This is again incorrect spelling. The correct spelling is APPROPRIATE. Appropriate. Then the third word is routine. R-O-U-T-I-N. This is again incorrect spelling. The correct spelling is R-O-U-T-I-N-E. Then the fourth word is convince. C-O-N-V-I-N-S-E. Again, this is incorrect spelling. The correct spelling is C-O-N-V-I-N-C-E. And the fifth word is arguing. That is A-R-G-U-E-I-N-G. The correct spelling is A-R-G-U-I-N-G. There is no E in this word. So that's all for today, students. Please learn these correct spellings. so that you can write them correctly. And I'll be continuing with the remaining exercise in my next video. Till then, please do learn and revise all the taught exercises of the taught chapters as your unit 1 exams are approaching. That's all for today. Thank you, students. Have a good day ahead.